Greetings, everyone. Grace and peace to all of you, members of Barre Congregational Church, and all our neighbors and friends in and around Barre. I'm Pastor Margaret Kaiser, and the deacons and I welcome you to this very special Christmas Eve service. Here to celebrate the birth of Christ, and we are doing it in a very unique way. We will be gathered virtually via YouTube, and I ask that we sit back and relax and prepare our hearts and minds for the blessings coming from God through scripture and beautiful music. I want to thank all who have made this service possible, from our deacons, to our organist, Deb Page, to our office manager, Wendy Isgro, and others who have just spent their time helping us to make this service possible. At the end of the service, you will see the names of everybody who contributed to the service, but I want to give a special thanks to our choir, who together with the Wesley United Methodist Church in Hadley, where my husband is going to and where I used to go to before I came to Barre, and they've put together something very special for us. I hope you will enjoy that. So let us sit back and may God bless us as we celebrate this Christmas Eve together. Let us pray. Dear God, we are grateful for this time, this Christmas Eve, where we can celebrate the birth of Christ. We've been waiting this Advent time for this moment, and here we are. Be with us now and bless our time together. Amen.
In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." Then the angel left her.
Thank you. And Mary said, My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him, from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their innermost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but he has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors.
I believe in the sun, even when it's not shining. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Luke 2, verses 8 through 20, the shepherds and the angels. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who had heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you. Rejoice, people of God, the light has come into our world. O God, now I light the candle of your nativity.
With the company of heaven and with sounds of great joy, you come to us. This is the time of light and resplendent joy.
The prophet Isaiah proclaimed a time when those who walked in the shadows would see a great light. A light would shine and a child would be born to us. The evangelist Luke painted the nativity sky and repeated the heavenly song of the angels. Glory, peace on earth, and goodwill. John declared that this great light is Christ, the Word made flesh. This great light lives among us. By it we behold God's glory, full of grace and truth. At Christ's nativity we now rejoice.
God, our life and light, thank you for coming this night to us. Thanks for touching all heaven and earth with your splendor. In every corner of the world, shine this night with your peace. In every corner of our hearts, shine this night with your grace. Amen.
What an amazing service this has been. I hope you feel as blessed as I do right now. I want to wish you a blessed Christmas day. Enjoy this Christmas Eve. And as we go forward, let us keep this hope alive that Christ is born and Christ is with us. Thanks again, everybody who made this service possible. Let us now receive the blessing from God and feel at peace. May the grace of God and the love of Christ and the presence of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen.